My approach to productivity is I use what I call an agile design approach. And that comes from my background as a designer, systems designer and software design, and the agile methodology, the approaches to design projects, where you change your actual approach to every project based on the complexity level, based on the degree of predictability of your resources and things like that. So you have to learn how to improvise, basically. Agile is a very improvisational approach to design. In other words, they don't focus a lot on documenting, planning, and scheduling. They focus on figuring out what the needs are and getting it done, meeting the needs. And that's my approach. I take a needs-centered approach to designing your life. And it's equivalent to an approach in psychology, which is getting away from fixing you to building solutions that work in your context and that change with you as you grow. What your symptomology is today, what your whole paradigm is today, shifts as you grow. What you're capable of, like say you learn a new habit or skill, what you're capable of 3 months from now is different than what you're capable of today. And so we leave the door open for you to grow and improve. And that's a whole new optimistic way of looking at who we are and how you can use design to heal yourself and continuously shift and change and realize some of the strategies you put in place in the beginning are just sort of band-aid measures so that you can focus on building. And like I like to say, it's like you can put a band-aid on a broken arm, but that doesn't fix the broken arm, you know? So you want to get to the core, but you're going to need the band-aid if there was blood, right? You're going to need the band-aid to stop the blood, and then you're going to work on the broken arm and let it heal.